Hey guys, and welcome back to Birth by Sleep. In the last episode, we finished up Vin's story. In this episode, we get to start someone else's story. Yeah. The final character. Yes.
It's everyone's favorite.
It's my favorite. John's favorite is Vin. I don't know. We'll see who your favorite is after this.
My favorite?
Yeah. Mm. After this one.
I'm a little bit undecisive at this point.
I mean, if you're undecided by now, you're probably like Aqua.
There is one little thing about Aqua that I don't like.
That is just a goody-goody-two-shoes of the bunch?
No. I think it's her vocal delivery that really bothers me. It sounds bland, like... There's not a lot of emotional aesthetics or something.
I see everything like this. I'm sad. I'm happy. Oh no, Tara. I raise my voice sometimes, but that's about
it. Least Vin can emote, you know, a bit. I can give props for that. Aqua doesn't really emote as much. That doesn't scream pedophilia. Those have to be some sharp shoes.
So, you know what I just realized?
Today you will be
Ericus and Xehanort had this battle, and Ericus had like darkness scarred on his face and everything, right? This is neither a competition. So at that point, it should be common sense not to let Xehanort back in here after that whole darkness fiasco. Because clearly his heart is eaten up by darkness. Ericus himself has experienced this. So why is he here?
I trust you are ready.
No.
Yes.
I demand an answer to this plot point.
I'll give you one in a second.
This plot hole.
Don't worry about me. You two focus on the exam.
But Ven, you're in danger here. Go wait in your room.
No way. I've been looking forward to this. Seeing you two become masters. I'm not gonna miss it now.
He can take care of himself. He's been out there training just as hard as us.
Yeah.
Stay sharp, Ven.
Anyway, to answer your question. Basically, that happened a really long time ago. Master Ericus wanted to believe he had changed.
No.
Wait, how far back a long time ago?
It's not really specified, actually.
Ericus and... Wait, no. I'm wrong. Aqua said, but darkness begets dark. Wait, no, that's wrong. Hate brings dark... Whatever. The point is, darkness begets darkness.
No, he said fear beckons the darkness.
I don't care. Darkness begets darkness.
He never said darkness begets darkness.
I know he didn't, but I'm saying.
Well, that's you, not him, so your point is still invalid.
Once an evil darkness villain, always an evil darkness villain.
Well, Riku was a villain.
That's true.
I mean, even with that, like these darkness orbs out of nowhere, this should say Eric was like, oh, something happened here. You should look back, it's like, oh, you didn't.
I totally did.
But no, we have this stupid plot point with Tara having darkness out of nowhere. It's like, oh, it probably came from him.
Damn it, Xehanort, you've had one job.
Why would Tara corrupt the light spears? Makes no sense, but whatever, that's probably why.
That was unexpected.
I trust Xehanort still. Even
in the most I'm surprised you questioned this just now.
I mean, I didn't notice it till now. Also,
one I chose to let unfold. Which brings us to your next trial.
I mean, He has no idea the darkness now, came from Xehanort, and he wasn't looking at him.
I mean, I don't care.
Well, then you don't he care know, about the plot point enough.
He knows his heart's full of light. He can make light orbs all day. He's not going to fill it with darkness.
When did he say it was full of light?
The light orbs, they're clearly full of light. Clearly.
Yes, but every heart has darkness.
Yes, but I don't think those are hearts.
Even his.
Yes, but I don't think they're hearts.
Yes, but that's not the point. The point is you're saying he should have known it came from Xehanort, even though he had no way of knowing it came from Xehanort.
But he himself said, well, this is unexpected. As it, like, he himself did not put forth that darkness, dude.
Yes, but you're saying he should know Xehanort did it, which is untrue.
Concerning what Xehanort did to his face, he has every right to suspect him.
Suspecting isn't the same as knowing.
Well, still. You should totally suspect
him. I can suspect you kick kittens in your sleep. But there is that doesn't make it true.
How did you know?
That is all. Aqua. As our newest Keyblade Master.
It's true. I go outside every sleepwalk. I go outside every night and I try to fight kittens and I kick them. Hey. One of my secrets out, guys.
Tara. He means ninja cats. They want his rice bowls.
Where did it come from?
Came from Xehanort. But oh, no one is smart enough to even suspect him.
What do you make of Ventus?
He ain't gonna cut it. Somebody's gotta break that loser in.
Not here, you won't. I have to.
What appearance!
I know that.
It's been established in cutscenes back then.
No! Home. So stupid! So much of the bad things that happened in this game could have been avoided. If people just, like, A, communicated, B, listened and noticed things.
New cutscene.
I don't believe you. It's it is, actually.
Yeah.
And a cutscene with Aqua.
And in so much as you are now Keyblade Master, you must always be conscious of... What is that?
What happened?
I don't know. Why isn't Ven here?
Very well, then.
I you want him in your room.
I will send my pupils to investigate. Yes, I understand.
Stop talking to Yen Sid. Farewell.
But Yen Sid's awesome.
That was my dear old friend Yen Sid. As you know, he is master no more, but he still keeps a close eye on the tides of light and darkness. His counsel serves as signposts on the road we wielders of the Keyblade must walk. All the more reason then for concern, for he tells me the princesses of heart are in danger, not only from the forces of darkness, as you may assume, but also from a new threat. One that feeds on negativity. Fledgling emotions that have taken monster form. Yen Sid calls them the Unversed. As wielders of the Keyblade, you are tasked with striking down any who would upset the balance of light and darkness. The Unversed are no exception. I tried to pass this news on to Master Xehanort, but my repeated attempts to reach him had failed. Doubt there is any connection, and yet this all troubles me.
Master Xehanort is gone?
So here we are. I need you two to get this situation under control. Eliminate the Unversed and find Master Xehanort.
You know, Ericus, he could have just went to the grocery store. Between. You ever think about that?
They use these forbidden pathways to travel between this world and countless others. The darkness looms closer than usual within these spaces, but your armor will protect you. Lastly, remember that order must be kept. You cannot tell anyone there are other worlds. Now go and fulfill your duty.
Yes, Master.
Terra, consider this an opportunity. A second chance for you to change my mind.
What?
You must know. I care for you like my own son. If I could have my way, I would name you Master in a second. But how can I, when you are so obsessed with power? Terra, you mustn't be afraid of losing. Fear leads to obsession with power, and obsession beckons the darkness. You must never forget.
Thank you, Master. I swear, I will not fail you again.
Too bad he does
Master,
just that.
I best be on my way.
Wait, Aqua. Before you depart, I have one other, well, call it a request, the utmost priority.
Yes?
I told Terra this could be a second chance to show the mark of mastery, and I meant it. However, that flicker of darkness he displayed during the examination, I can sense it runs very deep. If he were to... if those powers were to prove too much for him to handle, I want you to bring him back to me at once. It's for his own good. I could not bear to lose any of you to the darkness.
Of course. I would never let that happen. I promise you I will bring Terra back. Only this time, you'll see he has what it takes to be a master. He's not as weak as you think.
He's not as weak as you think, guys.
Hey, Ben.
Hey, Vinaru. Ventriloquist.
Veggie.
Vegetable. Ventrilo.
So that's how I want Ben's power to be based on vegetables.
No.
He summons tomatoes and throws them at people.
It's like in Super Mario Brothers 2.
Yeah.
No,
he mustn't. You have to bring him back.
Don't worry, Master.
I think Ven has the coolest one, though, but I like her, so.
Ven was more like a skateboard.
Yeah.
It's a hoverboard, get it right!
They're about the same.
No, it's not!
I suppose you don't forge a D-Link with, Ven.
Not yet.
But just
that was Ven.
I forged a D-Link with Ven and Terra.
Huh.
It did Ven, and then it did Tutorial, and then it did Terra.
Oh. You said earlier, though, in one episode, that you wish that there was more of a relationship between Terra and Ericus, in a way.
Yeah.
Didn't they show that in that cutscene, though?
No.
Didn't that?
I mean, they show it, like,
here.
For a brief moment. For that brief moment.
For that one moment, and, he's sad when he has to kill him. And that's it.
Let's get in the castle dreams.
Oh,
get
where do I go?
The castle of I'm tired of this stupid world already. In fact, I'm tired of every world now.
Even Radiant Garden?
Yes.
Even Stitch's world?
Yes.
Even the desert world?
I don't know how Square Enix pulled it off, but they managed to make you play through the same world 3 times and still have new content.
Unlike Shadow the Hedgehog. God, that game sucked.
Mademoiselle! Senorita! Wait!
You're speaking 2 different languages.
Aqua!
Tara!
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 Ven ran away from home.
What?
I think he left to go find you. Do you have any idea why?
No. Actually, just before I left, he tried to tell me something. I should have listened to what he had to say.
Oh. So, did you manage to locate Master Zaynorn?
No, but it seems he's looking for pure hearts filled with light.
Pure hearts filled with light?
All I can tell you is that his search hasn't taken him here.
All right. I'll stay and see if I can find more clues.
Okay. The prince is in the ballroom ahead. He might have some answers.
Thanks.
Aqua. You still have the same dream?
Well, yes.
There's this girl here. Her name is Cinderella. She made me realize how powerful it is just to believe. No matter how impossible things seem, a powerful enough dream will always be enough to light the darkness. If you see her, give her my thanks.
Will do.
I don't know what you're going on about.
You'll be alright. You won't give it to her.
In the 5 minutes we're gone, Tara already has having a life-changing moment with a princess about the importance of dreams. In the 5 minutes,
I forgot she does cartwheels.
Huh?
Yeah, she cartwheels.
Get it? Because she's a female.
No.
I don't believe that has anything to do with it. She's just more acrobatic than the others.
I suppose there's that too. It's just some random assumption. Nope.
I don't care what Tara said to do. I want to see what I can steal. I'm like John when he plays certain games.
Nope.
I mean, it's true. Like, the first thing you want to do in certain games is, what can I steal here?
You mean in terms of treasures?
Fireworks.
Fireworks.
Can I have this?
Is it possible if you get 2 air slides, you could combine it to have a better one?
No.
No?
No.
Oh, shoot.
Then how do you get
a longer dash then?
Just get dash. Fire dash, preferably.
Oh, fire dash.
Yeah, I think fire dash is the longest one.
Well, what about for that one sticker, though?
Probably... Wait, for what sticker?
Basically stickers in which I can't, you know, jump high enough to.
Either get a bunch of fire dashes and go to a higher level, and then fire dash over to it.
Or you could do it the normal way and wait till you get high jump and glide.
Yeah. Wait.
Which is a lot less.
Yeah.
Straining on the timing issue.
Yeah. You can at least wait on high jump. That is one thing.
Yeah. Some of them you can get them on high jump.
Yeah. One thing you can't wait on.
And what's the name of that power that you use all the time, John?
Mega Flare.
Mega Flare, okay.
Don't actually make 4 of them. Make like 1, and then you're good.
It'll take forever.
It actually doesn't take that long.
What are you grading to Mega Flare?
Think it's like Crawling Fire, Fishing Fire Go. Yeah, Crawling Fire and Fishing Fire Go. Both has to be max level.
I think there's this one move in which it's really, really useful. It's where you get, I think it's Cura or Curaga plus the block and Espina. You combine all those together, you get this equipped item in the game in which it's supposed to help you with defense a lot. thing that helps you fill up your HP too, I think.
Who are those ladies?
Oh, if I recall correctly, there is Lady Tremaine, and those are her daughters.
I love how she just asked a question earlier and he came rushing right back.
You came back?
Huh?
Oh, my apologies. I was mistaken.
How do you make that mistake?
Your Highness, I found this on the palace stairs.
A glass slipper.
One dropped by a lovely young lady, and I'll search far and wide to find the maiden to whom this belongs.
You will?
Of course, Your Highness. After all, you finally found someone whom you wish to marry. Upon hearing that happy news, your father, the king, has decreed that a quest shall begin immediately throughout the kingdom. And I will start with the closest residence, that of Lady Tremaine.
Why is he dancing?
In the 5 minutes Cinderella was gone, the king has already decreed a whole quest to find her.
I'd better pay her a visit.
Yes, let's pay her a visit.
Also, in the whole 5 minutes Cinderella was gone, the prince has already decided that he's going to marry her.
There's one thing, too. It's already been established that the glass slippers, you know, fit her beautifully.
Yes.
How did that one pair slip out of her feet? Foot?
I don't know.
Plot device.
There's gotta be more than just plot device.
The plot must move forward. Like, for real. If the plot doesn't move forward, then you don't have a plot.
But yeah, you gotta give it some logic though, at least.
Yeah.
I think what it could be is that she probably put her shoe over the other, and it caused it to slip off by accident.
I doubt it. She was rushing downstairs.
Yeah, but she could have just pulled up.
I don't think so.
It's better than just plot device. And you just wasted it.
Yeah.
Sounds like Sword in the Life.
Was that the only other world that was available to you?
Yeah, it was the only one. Yeah, Terra and Aqua start in the same world.
Terra starts in the same world. Remember, he starts here.
No.
He doesn't. Cinderella.
He does not.
Where does he start?
Enchanted Dominion.
Sleeping Beauty.
That's where Ventus starts.
No, he starts in Seven Dwarfs Land.
Yeah.
So you're telling me, in the 5 minutes they left, Terra went to Enchanted Dominion.
Yeah.
Did everything there.
Yeah.
And then did everything here.
Yeah.
In the 5 minutes that Aqua did not have her eyes on him.
Yeah.
Deal with it.
This is a wild goose chase.
No!
Technically, it is.
It's stupid!
I said it's a wild goose chase. What do you want from me? No, I don't want to freeze. No,
this is stupid.
I thought you liked the game.
I like the game.
I like the gameplay. I like fusing together things and making really retarded combinations and doing all sorts of bunch of different stuff and breaking the game and everything. I love doing that stuff. Here. But the game itself and its story and its plot.
John's not a fan of Kingdom Hearts.
I'm not. I can play the first one just fine. I can play this one, but that's it.
So I forgot I can move while doing that.
So far for me, I'm trying to get used to Dream Drop. The Dream Drop Distance for Kingdom Hearts 3.
Yeah, I've convinced myself to beat that before it comes out.
Yeah, we did talk about it, how Ben didn't like the drop system. Yeah, it was along those lines. But I do recall some people got pissed off about this one plot point, which it pretty much derails everything that we learned about the story so far.
Which is? Wait, no, no, no.
I'd rather
not
spoil.
Don't tell me.
Because you haven't even
played it before. Don't tell me. I'll find out.
You talk about the ending?
No, it has nothing to do with the ending. It's somewhere in the middle.
I at least know the ending.
I know the ending, too.
At least know the ending. Congratulations. I just gotta learn the rest of it.
Yep.
You won't know when Kingdom Hearts 3 comes out.
Wait, I tried Dream Drop Distance for a bit.
The drop system?
I mean, I actually like the drop system.
Do you?
Yeah, for once. I actually enjoyed it. I enjoyed the gameplay, but cutscenes? 3DS? 3DS? Cutscenes? The flow, whatever it's called. And the maps, like the general area to go around on. All four of those just maybe not want to play anymore.
Actually, I love everything except the drop system about the game. Except, I don't know, it's like when I play it on my 3DS, it seems like super quiet whenever the cutscenes come up.
I mean, I don't know, I feel like they could have done it much better. I feel like they would have been much more justice done to it if it was on the 3DS.
What would you have them put on? Let me guess, the PSP Vita?
Maybe. PSP Vita sounds nice, yeah.
Alright.
But then would it drive the sale of the console, though?
But you
not really.
But then you couldn't call it Dream Drop Distance 3D. Like, don't lie, you know that's the reason they did that.
It's probably not.
It totally is.
Probably not.
It wasn't that confirmed by Nintendo?
Even says it on the cartridge that Kingdom Hearts 3D, and then it says Dream Drop Distance.
Yeah, but that doesn't mean that's the reason it was on the 3DS.
I know they gave the reason why they emphasized the mini 3D. Based on the technical, based on the technical aesthetics.
3D's in the subtitle.
I was gonna say that it has something to do with the development of 3DS. But no. But no, I guess not.
Hey, a high potion you'll never use. Hey, a potion you'll never use.
Joink.
No, it's low.
Oh, a sticker.
Hey, a sticker.
Something you may never get.
Hey, a sticker you can't get yet. You can't even break for it.
Can't you get high jump just by doing melding commands?
No. You have to see it through story. This is boring.
Yay, magic increase. Maybe I can actually hurt stuff now.
So you know what the finish command in Spellweaver reminds me of?
What does it remind me of?
Blitz Beyblade!
I'm so glad I never watched that.
I never watched it either.
You're not really. I just thought the whole concept was really dumb to make a show out of.
Yeah, I guess. Even so.
I mean,
had a catchy theme.
Ooh!
I mean, at least go.
No!
Shinengo, whatever it's called, at least that was a bit interesting.
What's Shinengo?
It's a Japanese anime based on the Go board. You got these black and white stones.
Inugarunago?
I think that's what it's called.
Yeah, I've seen it. To the end, actually.
I'll be back.
It's sad.
What if every single unversed creature was voiced by John? Giving out sarcastic remarks.
No, do like a country accent for everything.
Yeehaw, we're gonna kill those Keyblade wielders.
No, just John going up to Aqua. So you're supposed to be a Keyblade master. I don't see it. It's like, okay, I'll go home now. Anyway, we're back. Screw you guys. I'm at level five, so I should be.
You were at level two.
Decent. I was at level one.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
Wait, couldn't you level up at the land of departure?
No, there's no enemies there.
Yeah. I was playing through this game just to go.
Like, you either grind here and die a few times but eventually get up, or you stick with it through here and then die a bunch of times later and then not come back here to grind.
And then grind there.
Yeah.
So either way, you're gonna have to end up grinding somewhere.
Yes.
But it's like, what I would recommend to you guys, and what I did was,
you enter one area,
that hallway back there is a pretty good place to grind, yeah. And then if you level up, there's a save point right here that you can use to keep your levels in case you want to quit or something. You can also use that save point if you're out here and fighting and you get low on health.
Yeah.
Just Aqua doesn't take too many hits, and it's kind of sad.
Listen again.
Imagine the guard. I can imagine like the host is just standing outside, taking a look at Aqua. He's probably thinking, "What the world is she doing?
Yeah.
What is she doing to my garden?
That's my precious fountain. Stay away from her."
So are you still grinding?
I love that delay.
What, the guard? Or...
Where like if you're in an animation, you'll still get hit. But only after it loads the whatever animation is trying to load in. It's kind of silly.
You know what else the finish command reminds me of?
What's that?
Giga Drill Breaker!
At least it's not Beyblades.
I told you what else it reminds me of. As in, not the same thing.
I'm half asleep at this point. Which is weird, because I'm usually not comfortable.
Alright. Yeah, I'm still trying to level a little bit. Alright, I got a treasure chest off screen. It's that one over there, where my blizzard just went.
Oh, we're still level grinding.
So why are you still grinding?
Because it never hurts.
Why are you doing this on screen?
Because I'm showing them stuff. I'm showing them enemy locations if they want to grind. Exactly what spawns there. Those big guys are actually, they do the most damage, so...
Wait, is this
probably for like the first two levels, I think you get defense after that.
Well, that and I think from the big guys, which I don't remember their names, you get the most experience points.
You do. I think you get, six.
I think it's six. The little ones don't really count. I think it's just a value of one.
Right. But they're better to start out with, though, because... Oh, yeah. The other thing is, see how that one blocked? Yeah, you can cut through their block with the Aqua's finish command. Pretty cool. Right here. Okay. What the? Oh. I missed. Oh. I forgot I don't have that,
Probably what at this it? Point, then in our way of flying the Kai Blade.
Just go. You he's could taking, just go.
He's taking... He's conquered all the worlds. Like all in, that happened just because Aqua
like considering that Terra just went through two complete worlds in 5 minutes, Terra's at the end. Terra's already done with this side of the story by now.
Good. He can have fun being dead.
His will is alive.
Can anybody imagine Yensid holding a keyboard?
No.
Well, it was established that he used to be a master.
It's Mickey's.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
So that third throne is Mickey's. In the land of Archer?
No. The keyblade Mickey uses, that's Yensid's.
Yeah.
That's what you're asking, right?
Well, I was establishing that Yensid used to be a master. I think he established that in Terra's story. I know that.
I mean, he established it here, too.
In Terra's Marvel story?
Yeah.
Okay.
He said even though he is master no more, he still keeps a close eye. Blah, 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 blah.
Alright.
I didn't know, though, that the keyboard belonged to, you know, to you instead of originally. It's kind of funny, though, too, because isn't that one keyboard is just belonging to you for a long time?
I'm gonna be very disappointed if Kingdom Hearts 3 comes out and Yid Sid does not pick his Keyblade up from Mickey and be like, douche, I want that Keyblade, I want to kick somebody's butt. And then just like, hone them with the Keyblade.
That would be cool.
Oh, Mimic.
I would not mind that, actually.
Be like, get out of the way, Mickey.
I mean, this one's mine. I mean, I don't know, Kingdom Hearts 3 is supposed to have Ferris wheels and amusement park rides as your attacks now, so...
Well, I think they're just summons.
That's... no. Like, you can summon stuff. Oh, well...
Yeah, that's what I said.
No. Well... For the Ferris wheel and stuff, yeah, you summon them. But for another one, like, I forgot what it's supposed to be. But apparently you get... From summoning it, you get, like, a jet skate. With guns, and then you jet skate around and shoot things like the wisdom form.
Yeah, from the
except game. I guess it's like bumper cars or something is what it's supposed to be.
Yeah, you got all of them. Got all the treasure.
I think stuff. You just go in there and you just bump into a cutscene.
You do. But new. New.
No.
Actually,
new
can
coming.
I add? What do I have?
Oh,
what's barrier
search?
You could get that.
Oh.
Just go.
He's a
I'm equipping things!
You know, equip stuff that's useful.
And then go.
What the? Command list?
Equip things, then go.
I'm working on it.
Could just go.
You know what would be really funny in Kingdom Hearts 3?
Yeah.
Whenever you highlight the new icons, it's replaced with the old icons, and you can't get rid of them.
No.
That would be awesome.
That's some Tetsuya and Nomura shit right there.
Exactly.
Just get confused.
Blizzard. Did I even use Blizzard? I'll use Blizzard. Because why not?
But you need to get that one to level 3 though, right?
Technically, I only need it at level 2, actually.
Really?
To get Blizzera, you need it at level 2. To get Blizzera, you have to get Blizzeras to level... There's other stuff you can do, too, but that's, like, the most common one.
You honor our humble home, my lord. Quite so. May I present my daughter, Grisella and Anastasia?
As I feared, there's darkness here.
Wait! It's dangerous to fight the darkness with light, my dear.
Who are you?
Cinderella's fairy godmother. I appear to those who believe that dreams come true.
Then I'm honored. But why would you advise me not to fight darkness with light?
Strong rays of sun create dark shadows. Sadly, Lady Tremaine and both her daughters are jealous of Cinderella's charm and beauty. Qualities that appear to you as light. Jealousy is darkness. Light and dark go hand in hand. You can't have one without the other.
Then, what should I do?
It's quite simple, dear. One of Cinderella's friends is trying very hard to keep her light from fading. I want you to join Little Jack and help him.
I can do that.
You'll need a bit of my magic to help, Jacques. Come back and see me when you're ready.
What, John?
Yes, John?
She introduced herself. I'm the fairy godmother. Like, I'm advertising.
What?
Bibbidi-bobbidi-boo.
Whatever.
Okay.
I don't understand.
Are you ready?
Yes, send me in!
Because we're already leveled up enough as it is.
Go under the beaches of Normandy.
Bibbidi
bobbidi D-Day.
Oh, goodness.
Wait, I regret this decision.
Do you regret this decision, but for different reasons.
Oh no, you made a mistake. Yes, suffer a little mouse.
Hey, it's a key mouse.
Are you okay?
Rinderelli, step muddy like a rinna rum. Gotta let her out. Gotta save Rinderelli.
Let me help you.
Oh, that's not like Ben fans. Do you ever meet a Ben?
I'm Aqua. But tell me how you know about Ben.
As a friend. Good friend! Ben van Hepperjack fixa Flinderelli to rest!
And where is he now?
Frook of a friend. Other friend.
I see. Then, you must have just missed Terra.
Can't understand why! It always fit perfectly before!
Quite enough of this. The next young lady, please.
Oh no, hear that! Gotta flurry! Flinderelli gotta try that flipper! Come on, come on, flurry!
Not flurry.
No, 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 no! I said not a flurry!
It's alright, leave the
Quick,
city.
Kill him, please! Escort mission!
Oh boy! You know what I realized?
It's an escort mission.
No. The keyblade opens up any lock, right?
Yep. So why do we need his
key? All she has to do is point the little ass keyblade into the keyhole. Boom, unlock, done.
But no, we need escort mission apparently.
Yeah. We gotta have escort mission.
Which are the lamest aspects in any video game ever.
Get out of here.
Yeah, yeah.
Nope. Don't
worry, Ben.
I could have swore like in the movie too, there were other mouses in the movie.
Yeah, that's like
no! Oh!
I always kind of like the round, fat one. The one with the yellow shirt.
Yeah. What about him?
I kind of wished he was in this too. He was another, you know, another character in the movie.
Why do they always start off these unversed cutscenes with the smallest unversed ever, and then they build up to the bigger ones? Why don't they just start with the big ones? That's how most, like, I don't know.
Oh, this one isn't as annoying. Good.
Because it would just make him a bigger target. Which would make it a lot easier.
Well, I think it's because Aqua's not that great starting out. Okay, here we are. Done. I learned Thunderbolt! Yay!
Yay! That wasn't really as hard, actually.
No, it wasn't.
Tedious.
I think they toned it down because Aqua's
combat difficulty is just ridiculous.
Yeah.
Which is really surprising in this case.
You're the only ladies here?
There's no one else, Your Grace.
Aqua's a lady.
Come on.
She's
hurry,
here.
Jack.
Do-do-do-do-do-do. Like walk cycle. Whoa! How did you get tall?
The power of light.
The power of bullshitting.
Oh, would it be alright if I tried on the glass slipper?
I met you at the palace. Unfortunately, you are not the young lady the prince is looking for.
Oh!
But I am a girl. I should at least be given a chance to try it on.
Who are you? And what are you doing in my house?
She's probably here to rob us.
Mother, do something!
That girl does not live here. I have only two daughters. I believe we're finished here, Your Grace.
Regardless, she means no harm. Here you are, my dear.
You can't over-exaggerate your walk cycle.
Your Grace, please wait. May I try it on?
Pay
no attention to her. She's just an imaginative child.
Madam, my orders were every maiden.
You should let her go first.
Thank you.
I actually want to thank you for teaching Tara he needs to keep believing.
What will I do?
Please, don't worry. You see, I have the other slipper.
Like she never took that into account.
Fit. I must inform the prince immediately. You will come with me, of course.
I'd be happy to.
It's not fair. She's a scullery maid.
Mother, are you just going to let them leave?
No. Cinderella will be put in her place.
You are a bitch, lady.
This isn't After Dark.
Her attitude, like...
What's that? What happened? Where is Cinderella?
She was attacked by a creature, a monster in the forest.
A monster?
And you didn't stay to fight?
Not another one. What could he do?
Yeah, what do you expect him to do?
Do some really exaggerated animation. How that you, foul fiend? And then he'll, kick him to death, by walking on air or something.
You expect so much.
What?
You expect so much from a lot of people.
I would.
Oh, I forgot recolors. Speaking of pumpkins.
Oh, well, what do you know?
This is what happens when you go against my wishes.
Did they just die?
Yes.
They literally died.
Yep.
On screen.
Good. Well, I would say off screen.
They died.
Good.
It's kind of like that implied punch thing where people punch them and you hear the punch sound, but it's looking over at the beach or something.
Yeah.
They died.
It's not really on screen, but it's not off screen.
But they died.
Yeah, so did Ericus.
Ericus died.
On screen, yes.
Yeah.
But these people died.
What the?
These minor whatever.
They're not really minor characters. They're more of the villains in the movie.
I know, but for this game...
I mean, I get that they're Cinderella's obstacle. Oh!
Yeah, I'm dead.
Whiplash!
I love how they also implied that they summoned the things when they themselves had no power to do so. And...
I thought they ever established how they did that.
What?
I mean, they didn't.
You got an issue with me, buddy?
What are you doing? You just stood there taking it.
Your long lost battle.
What the? Who are you de-linking?
No!
No one. You should de-link with someone.
Oh!
No, you want to.
I don't want to de-link with anybody.
Come on. De-link.
Okay. Nope. Get off, get off, get off!
You taste like Burbleberry.
I miss.
No. You don't have enough focus for the floor.
I'm sorry, young lady. I don't think it's time for you to die.
Oh my goodness.
Just blizzard him like a
or I could just whiplash you to death.
Okay, now do your thingy.
Well, no.
I'm gonna call home.
No!
Ben, do the show low Q. Stop coding the little pet shop or whatever.
Nope.
Come on, it's a giant plant killing.
It's a pumpkin.
It's a giant pumpkin that kills people. It's technically a plant.
Oh. A single slot strike!
Strike.
There you go. Add to performing bubble beam a bunch of them. It would be funny if one of them tripped on the stairs.
It would be bad if one of the urn verses pops out of nowhere and just kills them both.
I think the stair thing would be even worse. Because one of them's gonna fall flat on their face, and their face is gonna get disfigured, and then they're not gonna look
beautiful.
Pure
heart filled with light? It's strange. The master taught me darkness needs to be destroyed. But how, if not with light?
Oh, with love, dear. Right?
You're too young to know. Experience more things, and you'll find the answer. Just trust in your dreams.
Too young to know? How young is Aqua?
Not that old. Alright, so that's it for that world, and that's it
Castle
for this episode.
So you gotta do Keyblade.
I'm not doing it. Before the next episode, I'll try to level up a little bit more.
Come on.
Maybe I'll equip it off screen just to annoy John.
Come on, equip it.
In the next episode.
1 second, equip it.
In the hub world?
In the next episode, I think we're going to enchant it, don't mind. I can find that out.
Check the comment level.
Yeah, give me a second. I'll find that out.
I think you go to...
I think it's this one next.
Yeah.
We're going to see the Seven Dwarfs. That's next
Again.
Time.
Woo.
See you guys then. Bye.